Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 says, "Come unto me, all ye that labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Spurgeon said, "You could never preach too often on such a passage. The promises cheered the hearts and blessed the souls of so many down the years. And I trust that we will treasure the words from the lips of Jesus today, and that we will allow the Spirit of God just to minister them to our hearts." First thought is the command, come. Very simple, but yet so important. We've got to come to the Lord Jesus for salvation. Now you notice the Lord Jesus Christ didn't say, do this or do that. He said, come to me. As a father, when our kids were so small, I used to hold out my arms and say, come to Daddy. And of course, they knew exactly what I meant, even though we were so little. The Lord Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. But why come to Jesus? Because Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Praise God, Jesus didn't drive the sinner away, but he lovingly and tenderly invites you to come to him. But you say, how do I come? You come by faith. You come as you are. Acknowledge that you're a sinner. Accept that he alone is the only Savior. Charlotte Elliot wrote the words, just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. It is a personal command. You've got to come to Jesus. It is a present command. Come, come now. Don't wait another second. Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. But notice the company. All ye that labour and are heavy laden. Yes, all without exception. And yet, in a sense, it is restricted to those who acknowledge their need, those who are labouring and heavy laden. But who are they? To labour, the word means to be beaten out, exhausted by toil. And there's so many today that are labouring, they're working hard, they're trying to appease a righteous and a holy God, somehow that they will get favour in the sight of God by their works and their labours. They're trying their best, and yet sadly at the end, they never succeed with all their efforts. Man has tried and tried again, but he'll never find peace in his heart by his own efforts. For the Bible says, it is not of works, lest any man should boast. I cannot work my soul to save, but that my Lord has done. You know, it says, not only labour, but heavy laden. And those who are burdened down with a guilty conscience because of their sin and remorse over their sin. What an intolerable burden that weighs down and presses upon their soul. Is there no hope for such a person? Do you feel the weight of your sin today, the guilt of it? I want to tell you, this is what God says. Here's the consolation. I will give you rest. This rest is a divine gift. Notice he didn't say, I might. He says, I will give you rest. He doesn't say, I will show you how to get rest, or I will show you rest, or I will tell you off rest. No, he says, I will give it. I will give it. The blessed certainty you can receive from his loving, nail-pierced hands, that rest that only Jesus can bring. That's illustrated in Luke's Gospel, chapter 7. The woman came to the feet of Jesus, and as she stood there weeping, broken-hearted, and kneeled down at his feet, the people there, they scorned and scoffed at her because they remembered her past. And the Lord Jesus said about her, her sins, which are many. Yes, he knew all about her sin. He didn't try to minimize her sinful past. He said, her sins, which are many. And then he said to her, thy sins are forgiven thee. Thy faith has saved thee. Go in peace. Her life was changed that day. And praise God, if you come to Jesus Christ, he changed your life too. Maybe there's someone listening to me, a child of God, and you're burdened. Nobody knows how pressed down you are. You're heavy laden today. Maybe you're concerned about the whole situation, or the family, or finances, or food, or whatever it is. whatever your burden is, you bring that to the Lord. Come unto me, all ye that labour and are heavy laden. And here's his promise. I'll give you rest. You receive that rest. There's not a situation too mighty or a burden too heavy, but Jesus is able to carry you through. May you come to him. Lord Jesus, we thank thee for thy promise. Help us to claim it today and rest upon thee alone. I pray in your lovely name. Amen. From my heart to yours, home to yours. God bless you.